To add to this one very good point, because it's this polarization of labor force that everybody is discussing, of that you will have high wage demand for high wage paid jobs and a very low skill, but nothing in between, which will tremendously hurt middle class. Yeah, and middle class is very bad if you don't have it for democracy, for example. And therefore they said, okay, for this new digital economy, you need STEM qualification. But there is ongoing debate that this is not true, particularly the robots, they don't have creativity, and robots, they don't have emotions. So this is where humans are more, let's say, superior over machines and tools. And therefore, there are discussion of STEMs, that art should be part of this, that creativity part should be also used, and particularly for specialization and for adaptations to the tastes of locality. So that means Africa have a lot of potential there. You don't have resources, but you have a lot of creativity. Creativity should be leveraged in this new context. This should not be ignored. But I agree with Susan, so that means education system, regional innovation system, science, technology, innovation system completely have to be revisited in African countries, and also educational system should be revisited. So this is extremely important, and I think also global community should work together on this. This could be a very negative externality for the global community. Therefore, we should have some collective actions on this, education, and connectivity.